Hello friends, the title of this presentation I have kept Plagiarism and Optimization of Research Articles, a challenge of research and technology. So before I start this presentation and the points basically which I have thought to share with you all, myself, as you know, that Dr. Sushil Kumar, and today I have kept here my social media IDs. On YouTube, you know, Instagram, that is SushilK17, Twitter, that is same, Facebook, and like that. So you can find out me there. So nowadays, actually, you may have heard about to the plagiarism and publication ethics. So those point I want to share with you, with my experience, and it might be that if you notice anywhere that I am wrong, you please just raise your hand, give the message that this is the point at which you are wrong. But whatever I will share here, that is basically related to my experience. And so I am just taking an example here. Through this example, I will try to show you. There is a text actually here, you can see, and the plagiarism software basically checked it and highlighted the point. So this light yellowish color which you are observing here at the sixth number, what basically software suggests here, software actually suggests that this is the source. This text basically is taken from this particular source. While on the other hand, this author mentioned this particular citation, Wang et al. Of 2015. And when I checked it in the references, then it was written in this way, Wang C. Dao, and this complete information with the text and the name of the journal. So with this example, I just try to explain the thing which basically circulating among the researchers, and how much one is taking care of that. That is the different question, but the point is that everyone is now, everyone basically nowadays talking about the similarity index and plagiarism, and most of them are dependent only on the output of the software instead of checking that information manually. Everybody knows that whatever he is doing, that so much data online available related to that. And on a specific domain, if you start to work, there is no doubt that you will use different words to explain that particular phenomena. You have to use those words which are in common, right? So you cannot change those technical words. But what is going on? Reorientation of those key words. If you are perfect into that, then you are there is no similarity index. But if somehow you are not capable to rearrange the words in a proper order, where software check that, or you somehow change the language, then you are perfect. So I want to just point out this thing, which basically going to day by day in a different way, and people are misinterpreting this thing. Mostly are confused in between the similarity index and plagiarism. So through this example, basically my purpose is that if possible through this video, I will try to cover this thing, that confusion becomes clear actually. So here I have shown you this text, original text from the research article, and turn it in, that is the software through which I have observed the similarity index. And this software suggests this is this basically highlighted text is taken from this source. But author mentioned here this text is referred to this particular article, right? So this is the author's citation, and this software suggests this particular reference. When I goes into the detail and observe the things, first of all, I have observed the reference basically which was given by the author into the research paper, and I observed that this is a Chinese paper where the abstract is written only in English, right? So you can also search it. So there is no English version of that research article, only the abstract is given in English. And when I started to read it, this abstract here, and you can also observe that it's just talking about to the particulate matter, right? Nothing related to that which basically mentioned into the text. The text mentioned the joint FAO WHO expert committee on food additives JECFA conducted a comprehensive risk assessment of PAH in 2005. JECFA recommended keeping the content of PAH in food low, right? This is the text, and here author basically mentioned it. And now you can see here into the that article basically which author have mentioned here, characteristics and toxicity assessment of airborne particulate polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons of four background sites in China. So with the title, you basically can take the flavor that this article is not talking about to the same point which basically mentioned into the text. So the first mistake is of the author that he quoted here wrong reference, and because of that software basically what he did that suggested this particular reference, right? So let's see. Now software suggests this website as a reference, CCLAC. This is the website which basically software suggested that this article or this text is taken from this particular website. So when I started to follow this one, this is again a Chinese website, and here these basically are talking about to the energizer, and these are zinc, arginine, and this citrulline, like that. What is an energetic agent for middle age and elderly people? Points for selecting middle age and elderly people. Products 1 recommend for mature. Recommended types of comprehensive energy agents. So this website, if I take the English version of it, is talking about the energizer, not about that particular thing which basically here mentioned FAO/WHO. Expert committee on food additives. So here one can observe that the reference which is quoted by the author is totally wrong, and at the second point the reference given by the software, that is also totally wrong, right? So where is the problem? Problem came actually when the author has taken the text as it is, and second thing that he quoted the wrong references here, right? So this is the problem. Both are non-relevant references, but similarity index comes through those words, right? And those words number depends on the how much basically contribution of this particular website which this software suggests. It depends on the number of the words, right? compared to the total number of words into the article. So it may be 2%, it may be 3% or like that. So one can basically, the software measure the similarity index in that way. So when I started to find out the detail of it, then I have observed that this FAO, WHO Expert Committee on Food Additives, conducted a comprehensive risk assessment of PAH in 2005, was this particular reference here, chemical risks of that, and started to read about all these things. And from this screenshot, you can understand that whatever is written into the text, that basically is relevant to this particular topic here, right? Here, Joint FAO WHO Expert Committee on Food Additives. So this was the original source related to this text. But what the author did, author quoted here a wrong text, references, and because of that, software wherever observed the most probable combination of the words suggest that particular source, and so that software suggested earlier website, this one is the CCLAC is the source from where the text is taken. But here we have observed, and you may have noticed it, that both are wrong, software also. So if a person basically focus only on the software recommendation that similarity index is 30, similarity index is 10, so when they decide this similarity index factor 30%, 20%, whatever, do they really observe the fact through that process? Are they observe that quoted reference and their source? So if really those people who basically says that this is the reference and because of that there is some problem, do really they have checked all these facts? If not, one have to check actually it properly. Software not always tells us everything in a correct way. And this is not first time I have observed frequently this thing. And this happened maximum time when author basically quoted the wrong references, right? Or misinterpret the language, that basically paraphrasing of the language, when they start this kind of smartness. Instead of giving to the credit to the original source, they basically use the third party sources. And here, through this screenshot, you can see that software basically consider this introduction word also and give the source of 41. So now you can imagine that, and this is the turn it in software, right? So here you can observe that what the author basically did, and he software's put on every words a particular source here, 22 number 19, like that. So you can understand that where is the problem, right? So these are the things, and you have to consider it yourself that what basically the researchers are doing. So this is not the problem of a country, this is the problem of basically the people, the basically those who are basically giving the training to them, right? So and problem is basically everyone wants a PhD degree, and because of that there is some basically disturbance into the system. So at this platform I don't want to discuss that thing, but one have to be very careful when do the research. And I will discuss actually problem is of the resources, and if one is basically is following the this kind of research work, so now one can understand that where is the research is going, right? So the point is basically of the resources, limited resources, and those resources are not approachable to everyone. So that point I will discuss in other video. But here my purpose was that I basically bring this kind of information among the scientific society, that don't focus only on the percentage of similarity index. You have to check that manually also. So plagiarism, here in the last slide, you have seen that at every sentence basically is highlighted. So what one can conclude from it? The conclusion is simple, that that particular researcher don't know about to their field, the basic foundation of the research work. So there is a one more important point that one should know about to the it basically, this is the search engine optimization, and in research this is one of the important point. So in the next video I will discuss this point. Right. So thanks for watching this video. If you have any question or you want to ask anything related to the plagiarism or similarity index, you can ask. Right. So I want to go basically into the detail of these things. So similarity index is different thing, plagiarism is different thing, but people are misinterpreting both these things and not observing manually. They are totally dependent on the software, and I have shown here that most of the time software suggests a different kind of sources, right? That is not actual. So basically the thing is, if I show you here that point, point is that plagiarism software have one dictionary, and what basically the word or sentence you use, that convert into with the different combinations, so using the synonyms of the specific words, and then after with the with the help of algorithm on which that software is designed, it basically judge every sentence, every combination of the words with the database. And this database is basically scholarly articles database, like Scopus, Web of Science, PubMed, and different academic database, right? And the available of proceedings, newsletter, audio, video, whatever you can think, website, like that. So there is a big database. With that, that software basically extract the information. And it depends on the program, and it depends on the input basically, and all those things. So why basically plagiarism we observed? Plagiarism is that we have put some foundation of our research work, and when we put that foundation there, we give some proof of that our work, that this is the foundation of this work, and this is started by this way, and similar kind of research basically which observed in that duration. So that kind of information we provide into the introduction to make the foundation for our research work. And when one is not aware about to the foundation of the work, that who basically did that work originally, and first of all, and use the citation of the review article or the those article basically instead of the original source, right, the problem comes only then. So a good researcher always give the credit to the original work instead of the review article or any third article. And this is comes into the ethics, that we have to always give the credits to the original work or original author or whatever is the source is. And when we basically skip that concept and don't give the credit to that original source, then this plagiarism problem comes. You say that this is your sentence, this is your idea, but that idea, that sentences, or that work basically is already available on the database. Or you can say at different platform. So here I will suggest that a researcher should give the credit to the original source. One have to use relevant references. Sometimes you are not quoting properly your citation style, then also the problem comes. But when you are giving the credits to the original source, and then after software says that this is the similarity index, I don't think that one had to consider that thing. But remember here, when I say this statement that you are giving the credit, so you take the text as it is from the original source. No, you are basically first of all reading that article and understanding the work, and then after you conclude something. So that conclusion basically is coming from that particular source, and now you are writing that summary or conclusion in your own words, in your own way. That is not your idea, but that idea came from the other source. So then that time you have to give that credit of this particular idea to the original source. This is the point only. And in conclusion, in your conclusion, you cannot write the someone other statement or the idea. That is your work, and you are concluding something that will be totally different, right, from the other. So a similar work can be done by the other person, but the approach which you have used is totally different. And obviously the everything will be totally different, and you can basically cite the similar work which basically done earlier by the other researchers. So I will suggest some point here that you give the proper credit, citation style, detail, bibliographic information like name, title, year, volume, issue name of source and date of extraction. Note down every information and source. Don't do copy paste practice in references. Actually, this is the main problem in the present time, that people are reading the third party articles and they think that someone basically quoted some references within this text, so we have to just copy paste from there. And maximum time I have observed that when someone do this kind of activity, they don't judge the actual source, they don't verify the references. Sometimes volume is missing or misquoted in a wrong way, or issue number, or sometimes DOI is not working. So that problem comes only then when one basically copy paste, follow this copy paste practice in references. So these are some points basically by that one. One can basically avoid the plagiarism problem or similarity index problem in general. Paraphrasing in practice nowadays. Should we take external support to write the scientific draft? Personally, I will say no. If you are a researcher, then you don't need it. But if you are not capable to do everything on yourself, then you can take support in terms of the proofreading, in terms of the formatting of the articles, correction into the table, correction into the figure, like that. Right? That is must basically, which I feel. I don't want to show this picture at this time. So this was all about to the this idea which I was sharing with you. I hope you have noticed that point, the purpose by which I shared.